All right, I've had my fair share of psychopath teachers growing up, but I think my sixth grade math teacher takes the cake. He had a little bit of an anger problem, and on the surface, you wouldn't see it. If you seen him in public, you'd be like, oh, look at that guy. He likes Pringles and Miller Lite, probably, all right. But if you were a stupid kid in his math class, well, you got to see it firsthand, because he hated stupid children, which is unfortunate because he teaches sixth grade math. He's surrounded by stupid children. All it took is one stupid question, and he'd flip his shit.
Mr. Roberson, does the percent sign go before or after a number?
Anybody else got any stupid fucking questions? Huh? Anybody? I got 29 more bullets here. He was the first teacher I ever heard swear in class, which can be a little jarring the first time you hear it in a school setting.
It's the order of operations, Daniel. You can suck my ass if you think subtraction comes before parentheses. What kind of simple bitch are you? Jesus Christ. Like, whoa, wait a minute. Something's not right here. You're a teacher. You're supposed to say happy words.
You just had a lot of pent-up frustration. If he could just lay into the occasional kid, just maybe like an uppercut, knock one out every once in a while. But no, this isn't the 1930s, where if a kid gets a wrong answer, you can, like, push a bookshelf on him or something. He'd always intentionally try to find the most nervous kid, too. Make them answer problems on the board, just so he can make you look like a babbling idiot in front of the whole class. Hey, Billy, why are you sweating so much? You're freaking everybody out. Why don't you tell us what you have for problem three?
12?
Yeah, hi, school nurse.
If I have Billy pee in a cup, can you give him a drug test? Because he's obviously smoking crack if he thinks the answer's 12!
I'm pretty sure he'd just go home at night, crack open 15 beers, and just drink until he couldn't feel anymore.
Honey, dinner's done. I made your favorite. Cigarettes and Xanax. How was work today?
Fucking kids can't learn how to add fractions, Sharon. God damn it!
And sometimes he wouldn't just spaz out on one kid. Sometimes he'd spaz out in the entire class. Like if we were sitting there and he was trying to teach us new concept, and we were just not getting it, and he's just looking at our blank faces knowing that not a single goddamn word he's saying is sinking in.
What the hell's he talking about? This is worse than long division.
So one of his favorite things to do was make us copy things out of the math book that we had. All right, little assholes, since you can't comprehend anything except your goddamn Pokemon cards, why don't you get your math books out and copy pages 4 to 96?
So we'd have to sit there and like sketch the actual page in the math book. Like the diagrams, the page numbers, the fucking copyright information in the front of the book.
But I've never seen him as mad as the day he flipped out on my friend Corey. We're sitting there one day learning how to add fractions or some shit, and Corey's over there fucking off all day in class like he always does, which makes him a prime candidate to be made an example of by Mr. Roberson.
Hey Corey, take your dick out of your hand and tell me what answer you have for the problem on the board.
Oh man,
just add the numerators together, Corey. It's not that hard.
Numerators?
Which number's the numerator, Corey?
The bottom one?
Motherfucker!
Oh god, he's gonna kill me!
It's simple goddamn addition, Corey. They're our first graders who can't even wipe their ass proper. I could do this right now.
I don't know. I don't know the answer.
Can you wipe your ass properly, Corey?
Not really, no.
Corey, get your shit and go up to your first grade teacher and see if she'll let you sit in there and learn.
Are you serious?
Get the fuck out of my classroom!
Now, if we all weren't scared shitless, we would have been losing it right now. Because the look on Corey's face was priceless. So sure as shit, Corey marched up to his first grade teacher's class to sit with a bunch of six-year-olds to learn basic addition and how to wipe your ass properly.
Mr. Roberson sent me up here to learn. Oh, and to ask you why you can't do your fucking job right.
Now maybe I'm exaggerating a little bit on how psychopathic he was. He didn't shoot anybody with an M16. But if I am, I'm telling you right now, it's not by much. He was a psychopath, and his teaching methods were a little unorthodox, borderline abusive, you know, whatever. But I tell you what, I learned some goddamn mathematics, that's for goddamn sure.
Brewstew.com